Artemis, welcome to the moon, Andy Weir. I bounded over the gray, dusty terrain toward the huge dome to Conrad Bubble, as a lock, ringed with red light, stood distressingly far away. It's hard to run either 100 kilometers of Chiron, even in lunar gravity. But you'd be amazed how fast you can hustle when your life is on the line. Bob ran beside me. His voice came over the radio. Let me connect my tank to your shot. That'll just get you killed too. The liquid is huge, he huffed. I can see the gas escaping your tanks. Thanks for the fab talk. I'm the EVA master here, Bob said. Stop right now and let me cross-connect. Negative, I kept running. There was a fab light before the leak alarm. Metal fatigue got to be the valve assembly. If you cross-connect, we'll punctuate your line on a jagged edge. I'm willing to take the risk. I'm not willing to let you, I said. Trust me on this. I know metal. I switched to long, even hops. I felt like a slow motion, but it was the best way to move it all that weight. My helmet heads up display said the airlock was 52 meters away. I glanced and my arm lit out. My oxygen reserve plummeted while I watched, so I stopped watching. The long stride faded off. I was really howling ass now. I even left far behind, and he's the most skilled EVA master on the moon. That's the trick. Add more forward momentum every time you touch the ground. But that also means hitch hop is a tricky affair. If you screw up, we'll face plant and slide along the ground. EVA suits are tough, but it's the best not to grind them against regolith. You are going too fast. If you trim, you could crank your faceplate. Better than a sucking vacuum, I said. I've got maybe 10 seconds. I'm way behind you, he said. Don't wait for me. I only realized how fast I was going when the triangular flash of Conrad filled my view. They were growing very quickly. Shit! No time to slow down. I made one final leap and added a forward roll. I timed it just right. More out of luck than skill, and hit the wall with my feet. Okay, Bob was right. I'd been going way too fast. I hit the ground, scrambled to my feet, and clawed at the hatch crank. My ears popped, alarm blared in my helmet. The tank was on its last leg. It couldn't counteract the leak anymore. I pushed the hatch open and fell inside. I gasped for freeze and my vision blurred. I kicked the hatch closed, reached up to the emergency tank, and yanked out the fin. The top of the tank flew off and air flowed into the compartment. I came out so fast, half of it liquefied into fog particles from the cooling that comes with the rapid expansion. I felt the ground, barely conscious. I panted in my chute and suppressed the urge to puke. That was way the hell more exertion than I'm built for. The oxygen deprivation headache took root. I'd be with me for a few hours at least. I'd managed to get altitude sickness on the moon. That hiss died to a trickle, then finished. But finally made it to the hatch. I saw him peeking through the small round window. Stay close, he radioed. Kansas, I whizzed. Can you stand? Or should I call for an assistant? Bob couldn't come in without killing me. I was lying in the airlock into a bad shoot. But any of the 2,000 people inside the city could warp the airlock from the other side and drag me in. No need. I got to my hands and knee, then to my feet. I steadied myself against the control panel and initiated a cleanse. High fresh air jet blasted me from all angles. Gray lunar dust swirled in the airlock and got pulled into petrified bent along the wall. After a cleanse, the inner hatch door opened automatically. I stepped into an antechamber, resealed the inner hatch, and popped down on a bench. Bob cycled through the airlock the normal way, no dramatic emergency tank, which now had to be replaced, by the way. Just the normal pumps and valves method. After his cleanse cycle, he joined me in the antechamber. I obviously helped Bob out of his helmet and gloves. You should never make someone de-shoot themselves. Sure, it's doable, but it's a pain in the ass. There's a tradition to these things. He returned the favor. Well, that sucked, I said as he lifted my helmet up. You almost died. He stepped out of his chute. You should have listened to my instructions. I wriggled out of my chute and looked at the back. I pointed to the jagged piece of metal that was once a valve. Blown valve. Just like I said, metal fatigue. He peered at the valve and nodded. Okay, you are right to refuse cross-connection. Well done, but this still shouldn't have happened. Where the hell did you get that shot? I bought it, used. Why would you buy a used shot? Because I couldn't afford a new one. I barely had enough money for a used one. And you assholes won't let me join the guild until I own a shot. You should have saved up for a new one. Bob Lewis is a former US Marine with a no filch attitude. More important, he's the EVA Guild head trainer. He answered to the guild master, but Bob and Bob alone determines your suitability to become a member. And if you aren't a member, you aren't allowed to solo EVAs or lead groups to tourists on the surface. That's how guild work, dicks. So, how do I do? He snorted. Are you kidding me? You failed exam, Jed. You super duper failed. Why? I demanded. I did the world required manual, accomplished the world task, and finished the obstacle course in under 7 minutes. And when a near fatal problem occurred, I kept from endangering my partner and got safely back to town. He opened the locker and stacked his gloves and helmet inside. Your shoot is your responsibility. It failed. That means you failed. How can you blame me for that leak? Everything was fine when you headed out. This is a result-oriented profession. The moon's a mean old bitch. She doesn't care why your shot failed. She just killed you when it does. You should leave inspect your gear better. He hung the rest of his shoot on his custom length in the locker. Come on, Bob. Jazz, you almost died out there. How can I possibly give you a pass? He closed the locker and started to leave. You can retake the test in 6 months. I blocked his pass. That's so ridiculous. Why do I have to put my life on hold because of some arbitrary guild rule? Pay more attention to equipment inspection. He stepped around and out of the antechamber. And pay full price when you get that leak fixed. I watched him go, then slumped onto the bench. Fuck. Okay.